This coat of arms relief is a great DeskProto sample project, showing the DeskProto can handle vector data, geometry data and bitmap data, even when combined in one project. 9 years ago we made a tutorial video about it, however the DeskProto version 5 in that old video is obsolete now. The current version 7 makes this much easier, as will be shown in this new video. And, best of all, the coat of arms STL file is a free download. You can combine it with your own vector text and with your own bitmap image. Downloading the coat of arms STL file is easy. You can simply visit the DeskProto website. Here we are. Yes, and obviously under download you can find 3D models. It already is the coat of arms. You go to the coat of arms page and the first issue is downloading the geometry, which is available in two versions, flat version where this is flat and this is flat, and a curved version where both are curved. So this one can be used in the entry edition, and for the curved one you will need the expert edition of a multi-axis edition of DeskProto in order to make the text follow the curves. So we simply download, save file, and after unpacking the file we can open it in DeskProto. Here we are on my desktop. So let's start DeskProto, DeskProto version 7 multi-axis edition. Here it is. First step is to check the project parameters is indeed your machine selected here. For now, for our machine, this is okay. And what I want to do is load all three types of geometry. So I can load vector data here, I can load geometry data, and I can load a bitmap file here. Okay, let me start with loading the geometry data. They're all placed on my desktop. Where's my desktop? Here we are. And it's the STL file that we just downloaded that I want to open. Here we are. I started with the geometry, as that defines the block of material that we want to use. And my block is 230 millimeters wide. So let me check the size here on the scaling tab. It's now 131, so let me make that 226 to have 2 millimeters on both sides as a precaution. The other sides are scaled as well. So on the material I can make my block a bit larger at the 2 millimeters on both sides in order to get to my total size. On both sides, 2 millimeters added, and my block is 70 millimeters thick, and I want to add that on the top side, so 5 millimeters extra. Here we are on all sides. You can see a bit of reserve to make sure that the geometry is completely included in the block, and the 70 millimeters, the thickness is added on top because I want the bottom of my relief to be on the bottom of the block in order to have all material removed on the white areas. Okay, here we are. That is the block. That's the base geometry that I want to machine. And now I want to add an image on the shield and a text on the banner. Okay, let me start with the vector data for the text. I prepare that in a CAD file. However, it's not completely correct yet because I scaled the geometry and I haven't yet scaled the vector data. So again, to the part parameters, you notice now something has been added. When we previously opened the part parameters, all we could see were these geometry settings, but now we have both vector data and geometry data, so we also have vector settings, and you can see the settings for vector are different than for geometry. Okay, for geometry I entered a scale factor of this 1.7, etc. And when for vector data I apply the same, here we are, I get a warning, that's okay. Now you can see it's nicely aligned on top of the banner. Okay, that's the vector data, and the third type of data that I want to load is the bitmap file. Also prepared, we use the DeskProto alarm clock, so for rapid prototyping, that was the idea to have this clock. No racing for the clock for your prototypes, but it's still there. So now again, I open the part parameters, and no surprise, there is a third type of settings, the bitmap settings. The bitmap needs to be a bit smaller, XY transform custom, and I figured out a Y size of 100 millimeters would be okay. Here's okay the warning, because we have three types of geometry data. When I scale, the rest of the block won't be scaled, because that would distort the complete image. So I'll remove that. Here we are, now it's smaller, and I also found out the panning, 75 and 51. You have to do step by step to have that correctly aligned. Yes, most important are the Z settings. I want the white to be exactly on the shield, so with a height of 0, and the black things, the black details, I want those as a relief on top of the shield, so a positive value for black. So 0 for white and 2 for black, and then I want that relief projected onto the shield. So project bitmap relief onto the 3D part geometry. Okay, here we are. I have all details set for my part, and now I can continue with the operations. Note, these need to be bitmap operations. When I use a geometry operation, then the geometry will be machined, and also the material will be removed that would be needed to machine the relief of the clock, as it's on top of the shield. So I need to use bitmap operations. Add a bitmap operation, remove the geometry operation. Yes, here we are. Okay, for this first bitmap operation, I call it roughing. Here we are. For roughing, I use a custom layer height. As said, my block is 17 millimeters high. The ball nose cutter will go 3 millimeters below the bottom of the part, so it's 20 total reach. So when I have a layer thickness of 7, I'll have two layers of 7 and one of 6, and a skin important as well, half a millimeter. Here we are. Borders for bitmap operation, the default is no borders, but here I want to have the standard borders to remove a material all around the geometry. Okay, strategies okay. General, this cutter was okay. The precision, so 1.5 millimeter for distance between the toolpath and step size. And you have to check the speed values in order to see what's okay for your machine. So in most cases, the spindle speed will need to be a bit higher, and feed rate depends a lot on what your machine can handle. Okay, so let's calculate the toolpath for this first operation. You can see the three layers that I spoke about, and what I will do is now show you what will happen by showing a simulation of this part. Here we are, one operation. Let's calculate. Here is the simulation. Okay, just switch off the toolpath, and I will also switch off the bitmap image. Here we are. This is a simulation of the resulting part after roughing. So all material has been removed around the part, because the ball nose cutter went exactly the radius of the cutter below the bottom of the block. So you will need to use some spoil board below your wooden block. Okay, that was the roughing. Second operation will be semi-finish. Again, a bitmap operation, of course. Here we are, semi-finish. Again, operation parameters. I want to use a 3mm ball nose cutter. A bit more accurate, 3 toolpaths per millimeter. Again, check the feed rates. Thread is okay, no roughing set. Area is okay. Borders again, extra for cutter. Okay, here we are. Let's again calculate the toolpath only for this operation. Yes, here we are. You see the toolpath here. On this area, you don't see any toolpath because a skin was left for the roughing operation. So the toolpaths are now below the top of the material. So let's calculate the simulation, switch off the toolpath, and here we are, much more accurate than the result that we just had, but still not accurate enough. I want more detail here, so I add a finishing operation. Again, a bitmap operation, finishing. Yes, here we are. A smaller cutter, a 2mm ball nose. Yes, very accurate. So 10 toolpaths per millimeter, or 8 in fact. Strategy, no roughing, borders extra for cutter. And here I want to skip the horizontal area around the part because that has been done already. Again, calculate toolpath. Very many toolpaths as you will see, so it takes a bit more time. It will also take more time for machining. So let's switch off the toolpath and calculate the simulation. Well, nice detail. I also need to switch off the geometry here in order to have an accurate view. So this is a simulation of the part that we want to machine. And then as a next step, we want to engrave the text here on the banner. And that will be done in a vector operation. Okay, we continue. Again, add operation, but now vector operation. Let me call it the logo on banner. Yes. Small cutter, because the cutter needs to fit within the engraved within each character. So 1mm diameter cutter. Again, check speeds for this small cutter. The spindle speed needs to be higher because to have a correct real cutting speed. And C settings is 0.5mm deep is okay to have it perfectly visible. I cannot yet check this option. I'll come back on that later. For the text, I want to use pocketing, and I want to use all curves in the vector data. So you can see they are now black, they have been selected. Okay, next thing, why can't I say project on the geometry? I need that, otherwise the toolpath will be 0.5mm below the top of the block, and I want them 0.5mm below this curved surface. And because the surface is curved, I need to use this projection. Okay, DeskProto only allows to check this option when at least one geometry operation has been defined before the vector operation. In our case, we use bitmap operations, but DeskProto is not that intelligent that it understands that a bitmap operation in this case has done the same trick. So we simply add a geometry operation, call it dummy, and move it up one step, that it's before the vector operation, switch it off or make it invisible, I need to say, and now I can check the option project and give it an accurate calculation precision. Yes, so now I can calculate toolpath only for the vector operation. Here we are. The toolpaths are invisible as they are below the material, so in order to make them visible I update the simulation. And here we are, this is the part that we want to machine using these four operations, all operations except dummy. So as a last step in DeskProto, I can simply export all toolpaths. And these are use four different cutters, and my machine does not have does not have an automatic tool changer. So when I say save toolpath, it will write four files, code of arms, yes, save only the visible operations because I do not want to include the dummy operation. Here we are, did number one the roughing, now doing number two the finishing, number three, now number two semi-finishing, number three finishing, and the final one will be a very short one for the text. Here we are, we have created four NC files that now can be sent to the milling machine. And what happens on the machine, you can see that on a separate video about machining this coat of arms. Okay, so far DeskProto. The resulting relief in wood and a few more designs, a sports prize and a memorial sign, machined as mirror image in transparent material. Visit our website for more information and to download the software.